Okay, so last time we added this Divi clothing store layout from Elegant Themes, and we added in our first archive loop module to display our products here. In this lesson, we'll be adding a list grid switcher. You're going to see that it's super easy to do. This takes a few seconds and show you the different styling options. So let's go back to our backend here for our Divi site. And what we need to do is go back to that layout. Now, I want to show you one thing, though. There's two ways to get to that layout. I can either go to the Divi library, as probably makes the most sense to you, but we can also just go here to the BodyCommerce settings. And here we've got the layout that we have, and we can just say edit layout, and it'll actually open up the Divi library with that layout open in another tab for you. So I'm just going to drag that over here so I don't get confused, which is easy. And bam, you can see that we have exactly what we want right here. So to add the list grid switcher, which is one of the newer features in Divi BodyCommerce, but I think it's really awesome. Gives you some unique ways to display your products on the page and give the user more options to see how they want to see things. So we can go down here, and when we go to the grid options, you've got grid styles here. Now we've got a grid list view switch, and what that's going to do, you'll see it adds a little couple icons here at the top, one on the left for grid view, and then of course one for the list view. You can decide which side of the page you want that on, and I'll actually show you where to do that now. But you can also see here that our height cards are different heights. You can equalize them, and then you can align the last module at the bottom. So that means the button would be aligned to the bottom of our page here. Now, not visual builder compatible, but I wanted to show you that because some people like these cards to be the exact same height. For me, I don't really care. I would just go with a masonry layout instead, and if that was the case, but to each their own. Cool. So grid list view options, that's the next one. So you can select the default state. Now I prefer grid view personally, and you can decide which side you want these icons to be on. I'm moving them to the right. Again, not visual builder compatible yet, but it will be in the future. For cookie time, what is this? Well, if it's set to zero, it means that it's going to be a session cookie. So the moment the person leaves your website, it's going to forget what state the list grid switcher was on. If you set it to 1 or 30 or 365, those are days. So that's the amount of days it will preserve the state that the user browsed the site on last. So if they go from here, they go to Reddit, and they come back, it'll remember how they prefer to view the site on that specific page. You need to set that for each list grid switcher. Now I'm going to keep mine as a session cookie. And now we can go to the design settings here. In the design settings, you've got your grid list view button. Over here, you can change the icon. You can change the color of the icon. You can do all sorts of stuff. The background, you can change pretty much anything about it. You can make it rounded. So if you wanted to add 5 pixels of curvature, you can see there that it added it, and it will do it for both of them. So let's go ahead and save that up and check it out on the front end, because that's where we have all the fun. Okay, back on the front end, I'm just going to use Command R, and there we go. We've got our list grid switcher here on the right hand, and list view, grid view. Beautiful. Now, one thing to note here is that the way that this works is that within BodyCommerce, it will actually automatically build or move your list view over. So what you need to do is just build it as a regular grid view card, and then it'll know which modules need to go which side with the magic of CSS. And a cool thing about this feature also is that we're not double loading layouts. We're doing everything with CSS. So we're literally just moving the things on the page. When you do build a custom loop layout, which we will be doing later, you can add certain classes to have certain structures be maintained throughout list and grid views. So maybe you always want the title to be on the bottom and you didn't want to switch it over there. There's classes you can add that will make that happen for you. You can keep things side by side. There's all sorts of other stuff that you can do. But more on that when we start building this out. But that's how simple it is to add a list grid switcher to your shop page layout. Very cool. So next up, we're going to be taking a look at adding some order by options, custom sorting options to the top here also. So let's get ready and get to it.